apparently Boy George is coming here.
We'd known for weeks a huge question mark had hung over Boy George coming to our shores.
He might not make it because he's having immigration issues, you know, like Chris Brown did for a prior conviction. Right.
So we had this big interview lined up. Big fan of Boy George, so I was very excited. He was in Canada. I did the interview over the phone and he had a big announcement for his Kiwi fans.
I'm told yesterday that we got our approval, and so I'm very excited about that.
Culture Club fans would be excited too. Do you really
want to hurt me? I've always said, you know, why are we not going to New Zealand? So finally, we are.
The touring show sounds fantastic.
The show is, you know, a rock and roll show. Obviously, there's no special effects. It's essentially about celebrating the music of Culture Club.
A hark back to the 80s with one of the most iconic bands. Millions of albums sold, number one hits, and a fabulously flamboyant frontman whose sexuality pushed boundaries. But there's much more to Boy George's past. Drug addiction and convictions, these are issues that journalistically should be addressed. And at first, he seemed happy to answer.
If talking about my story, you know, inspires someone to get clean and change their lives, then that's a wonderful thing, and that's something I'm very keen to do.
The most serious of Boy George's crimes was in 2008. An assault on a male escort, he handcuffed him and beat him with a chain. He was sentenced to 15 months in jail, an incident he's put behind him.
I'm coming up to 9 years sober. I'm very lucky that, you know, after addiction, I have my wonderful life to come back to. You know, music, touring, recording, doing The Voice was an incredible opportunity.
But it was when George was named as a mentor on The Voice in the UK earlier this year. That was when his crime hit the headlines again. The victim slamming the BBC for hiring him after never receiving an apology.
So we decided that we needed to ask George about it. As far as we were concerned, he hadn't talked about it before, and it was part of the reason why he was struggling to get his visa to play here in New Zealand. So I asked the question, and it wasn't well received.
You know what? Why don't you move on to something that's, you know, helpful? You know what I mean? Facts, do you know what? Thank you.
I was genuinely shocked when that happened because we had had such a good interview up until that point and there was nothing that led me to believe that he was even remotely uncomfortable talking about it. And because we'd talked about the immigration issues, we felt like it was relevant. And yeah, it was a real shame because he was very, very likeable.
I think he'll get over it.
Yeah.
I think we'll all move on somehow, don't we?
Yeah, I think we will.
Would you go to a show, meet him at the airport? Why don't we just meet him at the airport and go, "Hi, I'm the one, welcome to New Zealand," give him a little gift basket and say, you know,
somehow I think he's done with me.
Oh,
he did tweet after the interview, have a look at this, and said, "Just did a stinking interview for New Zealand, which I ended Robert Downey Jr. styles. Now I need my own movie franchise." I guess he's being a little upbeat there, isn't he? Sounds like he's moved on.
I think he'll be okay, eh? Good on.